Hey, buddy, it's Evicta. It's time for another run here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Repentance series. Happy Friday, Mosh Pit. Hope you all had a great start to your awesome Fridays here. Let's go on and kick off a brand new weekend. Thank you all very much for the support this past week. We've had a lot of fun runs, a lot of crazy runs, especially on Wacky Wednesday that everybody liked, and I am still hoping for we get an even crazier run today. Although yesterday's run might have taken the cake for me as my favorite this week so far. Though it might be a little bit biased on that. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Frog of the Night. Title thread was, I think I got the wrong copy of Isaac. This is after more than a few wavy cap uses. And yes, that is true. I honestly, when I first saw the screenshot on the Reddit, I thought that someone had just taken the WWE, like, you know, Raw logo for Monday Night Raw and put it on there because it kind of looked like the old logo. But then I realized, nope, that's definitely wavy cap. So thank you very much, Frog of the Night, and everyone who upvoted that one. Here we go. Let's kick off this Friday right, shall we? Victor Romeo, Mike Golf, Mike X-Ray Yankee Delta. We got great tears rate to start off with. Also a Sun card and Curse the Lost. And the undefined active item. I was going to say active ability, but that doesn't make much sense here. We got to be careful as the Claudies are trying to plot against us here. We are very... Very, very well familiar with Claudies here. We don't want this green champion to get caught on fire. So I'm going to try to do my best to get rid of the fires in the room first just because we don't want him going crazy, especially when he splits like that. Yeah, it just makes things a lot easier for us. Obviously, the Sun card is going to be completely useless because we've got Curse of the Lost. So, you know, that. But this is a fantastic start here for us here. 3.06 damage. Not the best damage, but certainly not the worst. And our tears rate being 3.20 is fantastic. Even our movement speed is great too, 1.13. I'll take this start all day, every day, including 3 HP. Like, it's one of the better starts that we've seen in quite a while. We can use one of the bombs to go get that sticky nickel if I so desired. But more importantly, we have this tinted Raku, which I will be opening up. Hopefully soon. Speaking of opening up, I will be opening up a box, or a case, I should say, of Star Wars Galaxies tonight. That should be a lot of fun on stream, so stay tuned for that. People have asked me if I'm gonna open up a sports card slash just card collectible channel. I've thought about it, but like, I can't even like dedicate a full like, I can't even really fully dedicate to the gaming channel right now because it's just like I've got a bunch of ideas, but none of them are stuff that like. None of them are like ideas that like I'm super jazzed on. So, you know, if I did like a sports cards channel or like a Star Wars cards channel or just a collectibles channel, you know, I wouldn't want to just post the streams there and then that's it. I'd want to like have a little bit of a breakdown. I don't know. There's all kinds of ideas that I have there. It's just all that kind of stuff. Just I want to make sure if I were ever to do something like that, it would be done right. And I don't think that I'd be able to do it the way that I'd want to and still have my sanity because like, you know. It takes between streaming and the band and you know doing Isaac and everything. It's a lot of time, man. It takes a lot of surprising amounts of time on top of like just trying to have like a semi-normal social life. Which, yeah, that's a different other can of worms altogether here. So we are going to get our Soul Heart from Blue Famine after getting the Orbital here. We curved one of those tiers, and it just destroyed our Hallowed Ground, which is an item that I haven't even talked about yet on this run. Okay, honestly, like, I'm getting tired of just getting knocked around here by this famine, and I've had enough. Your boy's had enough of that. I think I will, because we have 4 bombs, I will go and get that sticky nickel. Tech Zero, by the way, was the item that we got from our shop or our item room, obviously. Tech Zero is going to give us that lightning beam that you see there. We had another heart. I won't go pick up that soul heart until after we're done with the floor for obvious reasons. I don't want to actually take damage on it and then lose our double deal possibility anyway of our double deal on the next floor. One bomb should be able to get those 2 there, so it's a very good deal. And we get a key as well. Very nice. Very nice. I mean, sure, like, member card might be okay. I'm going to pass on it. The problem that I have with membership card is the fact that, like, it already costs you 15 cents, right? And then on top of that, for you to actually have any sort of benefit, you have to have the amount of money to buy one of like the more elite card or elite items that you want. I've got cards on my mind now. Second try here for the I Am Error Room is not going to happen. I can't pretend that I saw that this was a fool card, so I'm going to pay the price. I'm not going to cheat the system here. Okay, so at the end of the day, we end up getting a Soul Heart. We have a Sun card for the next floor. Hopefully, it's not Curse of Lost. And we got an Orbital, which, you know, is kind of whatever. Curse of the Unknown. We're going to use the Sun card, and we get a Soul Heart just randomly there. So I'll take that. There's a Mullaboom. This red Mullaboom might be able to give us access to the secret room, and it does. So very nice little timing there on the free entrance to our secret room, because now this allows us to go into the shop if we wanted to, just by the cost of our one and only bomb. Obviously, I'm not going to do that, however, because we have six keys, so we can still go see what's not in there. So, you know, that. And again, going back to membership card, it's just one of those things that, like, you know, I use my experience in the game to kind of gauge whether or not, like, a gamble is really worth it. Most of the time, it's not. I'd much rather have a premium item from the store rather than buy, like, use 15 cents now and then, like, go into the member shop and then not be able to afford anything in there anyway without bombing my donation machine. So to me, there's no real value there. To me, anyway. We're not even going to get a full charge on Undefined. Like, you go buy one in the store, but... You get the Apple, though, and the Apple, of course, is going to give us the Razor Blade shot and also a very nice Tears Up. Razor Blades that Isaac fires out can do double damage, which is very good. Combine that with the with Tech Zero, and we've got ourselves a recipe for a very solid early game here. We could definitely go and buy. I didn't see that was a green champion. We could definitely go and play that Temperance Machine a little bit. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself because I don't exactly remember how many hearts we have. There we go. We get a free tap there. Another free tap. Thanks to Hallowed Ground. Another one. And another one. There we go. So I'm going to stop there because I honestly don't remember. It's something you should do, by the way. This is something you absolutely should do. If you find yourself in a situation like this and you have Hallowed Ground, you should walk out and walk back in and drop the Hallowed Ground in somewhere else, like have them overlap. I don't know if that aura, if the immunity buff... Oh, we will get a full charge. I don't know if that immunity buff proc chance stacks. I think it does, but that just gives you more of an opportunity for it to proc, so you don't accidentally, like... You know, slide off the side and miss out on the aura while you're tapping the Tempest Machine. Again, it's a little nitpicky, but I'm not too worried about something like that. It's just a strategy that you could do if you wanted to. Get Orange Champion Limehorn here. Obviously the most dangerous of the Limehorns because of the fact those flaming bombs that he throws out, not only do they just leave red candle fires behind, but also the bombs that he summons will deal contact damage to you. They gotta be very, very cautious about where he is. And we do get a devil deal, obviously. Tower card, and we get Judas's freaking shadow. You know, now's a good time for us to turn into Black Judas. I think we definitely should. I'm gonna take Judas's shadow first, just in case if I mistimed and misjudged the amount of red hearts that we had or don't have. And then I'm gonna take Rotten Baby. And that should put us down to, I believe, just one heart, maybe. We don't have to... We do not have... We're actually more than that because we're not leaving a little pea puddle behind. So, yeah, I think we might still have one soul heart and one red heart. I guess we'll find out. Yep, I was right. And, yes, I did forget to use Undefined. I'll make up for it here. You know, the D12 ain't bad. The D12 ain't bad at all. Rerolling the rocks, giving yourself the ability to maybe give yourself some Tinnen rocks. You know, you can get Fool's Gold rocks out of there. You can get the quarter. You know, the D12 is honestly, like, it's not bad at all. I'm not going to say it's goated, but it's real good. It is highly undervalued and underrated, I think, by some people. Double Soul Heart here. I'm going to not commit to the idea of turning into Black Judas yet. Reason being is because I'd rather sneak another Devil Deal out while we can and get some more value. I still want to turn into Black Judas for, you know, damage reasons and damage multiplier reasons, but there's no reason to just throw it away right now. Let's hold off on that. Now, if we end up finding a bunch of Soul Hearts, then I will do it, but I think that patience is key here. I'm going to use the D12 first, and I'm just going to let the... No, I'll save it. I was going to let the Curse the Tower card, or the Tower card rip, but I think I'd rather save it for the boss. We get blue fires that spawn, or that don't do anything, but... You know, if there's anything in here that is vulnerable to fire, it'll cancel that out. And destroy them. We only have two bombs. It's not really worth us to use one bomb to get maybe one soul heart when it's not guaranteed, of course. Okay, got another roll ready to go on the D-Twizzle. I will take the blanket, which does give us a soul heart, and I will take the stopwatch as well, which gives us a movement speed upgrade. Mom's key could be pretty fire here. Obviously, we also get the slowdown effect from the stopwatch, as you can clearly see. Job by Rotten Baby, keeping up with the DPS, I like it. And that's another sort of motivating factor. It's the reason why I want to turn into Black Judas sooner than later, is because of the fact that we have Rotten Baby. And Rotten Baby gives us a lot of extra DPS that we can use for bosses and, well, just, you know, just use in general. I am going to go into the curse room here, and we get a little horn, which, you know, ain't bad. I ain't gonna complain about that. It's a very good tier effect to go along with our already good tier effects here. I think Little Horn being the premier tier effect that we have out of the three that we've currently possessing. Yeah. Leave the Lover's card, and we're gonna use the Tower card on the boss. Still not 100% sure where the secret room could be. I mean, it might be here, but not fully convinced on that. Weird how they all piled up right at the back of Mega Fatty, but Bighorn in there and slapping the backside of him. Get an easy peasy kill on Mega Fatty. Get a death card as well. And yeah, I think let's roll with the D12. I like the D12. This is absolutely a D12 room. Look at how many rocks are going to roll here. We got a crawl space out of one of them. I don't think I've ever seen that. I mean, I know that you can get crawl spaces, but never, like, just flat out spawned. I think what happened there is that the rock that was covering this crawl space was destroyed and re-rolled into, like, poop or something, and then that can't cover a crawl space, so that's what revealed it. So, look at that. D12. I'm telling you, man, the D12 is legit. It is legit good. It may not be the GOAT spacebar item, but it's... It's one that not enough people give credit to for being just really, really solid. I mean, game-changing good. E12 is ready to rock and roll again.
Or should I say, ready to roll the rocks?
We'll do it now before we're done. Get another crawl space. What the heck? looking for our item room in our store. Store less so. I mean, getting Mom's key would have been nice, but we just can't afford it. But now we're getting to the we're getting to the portions of the run now where we need to get. Look at that. We gave ourselves a tin and rock. We need to start getting some damage. I mean, we always need damage, but it's do or die here in terms of, like, are we going to turn into Black Judas now or wait for the devil deal? And with a 68% chance, you know, it's not a guarantee for sure. But you hope that you get it. Get Venus here. I'm actually going to wait on Venus because I think that we pretty much have to turn into Black Judas on this floor. So a sidestep dodge there, and then we get hit right from behind. Fast bombs. Fast bombs are okay. And we're kind of heavily relying on Rotten Baby right now to do a lot of the lifting in terms of those far range. Those far-ranging but kind of dangerous enemies to get close to mobs that were like Mr. Mines and those sorts, Mullabooms as well. Go to the shop. We get Blue Candle. I'm happy that there is a Soul Heart in there that's gonna make turning into Black Judas even better for us. Minding the spike rock there. Okay, so ideally, we would get ourselves a devil dew here and then turn into Black Judas. That is the dream scenario there. Nice job by Rotten Baby and Tech Zero taking out that first bomb and charger combo. Okay, so what we want to have happen here is devil deal, turn into Black Judas, and then we go back. Get the Soul Heart from the shop, get Venus as well so we can get ourselves an extra HP. Because remember, unlike in Afterbirth Plus and Rebirth, Black Judas cannot get Red Heart upgrades anymore. Drop a bomb there for Chubb to snack on. He looked a little hungry. Okay, we get a range up and tears up. I'm gonna leave that for now. Of course, it's a Krampus fight. And we get that of Krampus. All right. Honestly, give me the D12. Screw Krampus. Okay, so now. What we can do is we can either sacrifice ourselves or play a temperance machine inside of the arcade for money. I think I'd rather take my chances here. Didn't get the random chest, unfortunately. A little bit frustrating that it ended up going to a Krampus fight, but what can you do? We are now Black Judas, and that gives us a huge amount of extra damage here, which is exactly what we wanted. We got 5 bombs, so I might as well check these fires here. And honestly, having the D12 is going to make Black Judas a lot more solid. I mean, he's one of the best characters in the game, but wow, look at that. We get a dime out of that, thanks to the D12. And we get a Soul Heart as well. That's what I'm talking about, man. I'm telling you, the D12 is just solid. A rock solid item. Buy the Soul Heart here. We could buy a Sharp Key for 5 additional keys. I don't really think we need to. Then we get a Tears Up and Range Upgrade here from Mr. Dolly, which drops us 2 Soul Hearts as well. Oh man, big time plays. And Curse the Blind. Well, we've already gotten one planetarium, so I'm not super convinced that we need to go into this item room. He could get another one. Now, Venus is not a... Venus is okay. It's not the greatest of planetarium items, but it's certainly not the worst either. You're going the wrong way, and... I will go back here. I'm just gonna... While we're here, we might as well go check for a, we'll also go check for a soul heart in the shop. A couple extra cents there, courtesy of the petrified poop combo that we got. You just see the amount of extra damage that we're doing here, courtesy of Rotten Baby. Even Apple getting involved in that. Mom's box. Yeah, I think we gotta go. I think we gotta go with that. We didn't, you know, in yesterday's run, Mom's box didn't get a fair shake, and it's a great item. Like, I love Mom's box, but we were having too much fun with yesterday's run. Here, it's a little bit more of a pressing issue here, especially with us having car battery. I think the car battery makes a world of difference, giving us two trinkets every time that we roll it. On top of that, getting the doubled effect from any trinket that we're currently holding on to. So, yeah. So, sign me up for that. We meant no disrespect yesterday, Mom's box. It's just that, you know, we were having fun with Super Legs. Come on now. And have a little bit of fun. I mean, that does still exist in this game, I believe, anyway. I am going to go with the Locust of Death, even though the Wooden Cross is okay. The Locust of Death giving us those sweet, sweet fly DPS upgrades. And I don't know about getting to Boss Rush. False PhD, which is rain damage up, and you see here it's a huge damage up because we're Black Judas. Absolutely huge, beefy damage ups that we can get because we're Black Judas, and that's exactly the reason why I was so pressing on trying to get the transformation done sooner rather than later. And you just saw that right there. We gained two damage from taking one range down pill. That is incredible. So, False PhD, I didn't mean to slander your good name. There are certain situations where I do think that you are absolutely welcome to the run, and this is one of those times. But it's, make no mistake about it, it's not because of you. It's not because of you, False PhD. It's because of us being Judas. Any hope and dream that we had getting to Boss Rush is now dead. Excuse me a moment. Sorry about that. A flat file. It could take away the spikes here, but I'm not sure if the secret room's there. Oh, it is. Wow. Weird spot for it. Counterfeit Penny. Counterfeit Penny is very good, but this is the last floor. And that will be it. Any chance that we have making Boss Rush is now super duper done. Which is unfortunate, but, you know, that's just how it be sometimes. So if you're wondering where the charming effect is coming from here, that is coming from the Venus item. Anytime Isaac faces an enemy, he has a chance to charm it, and that is a 4 damage upgrade brought to you by Curved Horn, courtesy of Mom's Box. Wow. Yeah, now we're starting to get to somewhere crazy, and we have not found the store or the item room. How does he do it? Really, the only two things that I ever look for on any given floor other than the boss room is the item store and the item shop, especially when we have enough money to utilize the store. Being a store, by the way, I did see last week people's recommendations about the game that I was talking about, which was, you know, wanting to make a game that was like a TCG shop owner simulator. heavy emphasis on like opening packs and the business side of things. And many, many people said that there is a game that's right up my alley, and it's called TCG Tycoon Simulator or something like that. I downloaded it, but I have not played it yet at the time of this recording. So, but I do appreciate everyone's recommendation on that. I cannot believe the item room is the last room that we've seen on this floor. I mean, let's be honest, I can believe it, but their full card, which we're just going to ignore at this point. So I still would be like super duper interested in making my own version, because I think that, and I've seen screenshots of the TCG Tycoon Simulator, and it definitely looks to be like what I was talking about, you know, buying packs and stuff and that sort of thing. I would want to do something similar to that, but have my own take on it. Maybe even, I think it would be cool to even have like a true blue TCG within the game itself. Like just have like nothing crazy, but a simple game, you know? I think that'd be really neat. Oh, 73% deal with the devil, and yep, you're used to that by now, aren't you? Once again, we get another huge damage upgrade here, courtesy of the Black Judas multiplier. That shot looked like it came back on us. That was weird. Maybe that was us getting displaced by Hallow Ground and get old dead end here. All right. Go check up here. How does he do it? Someone said that they are working on getting a yes, I saw that Tinder Rock. They are working on trying to figure out how they could prove statistically that Sinvicta navigation defies math. So I'm very eagerly waiting that one. The fact that we somehow unbelievably managed to continue to find ourselves and going the wrong way in almost every single floor that we go to. It really is absurd and defies logic. It defies everything but math, and we're trying to prove that now. Very infamous comment now. Mathematically impossible that he would run into so many dead ends without actually trying. Which, I'm not. The last thing I want to do is stay on a level any room for one room longer than I need to be. A late game HP upgrade. I am going to take Bloody Gust, though. It is kind of BS that we get a skeleton hand inside of the devil deal. I think it should just be the regular mom hands. All right, now we got to be careful here. We're not totally invincible, despite our damage and appearance here. I would say statistically, this is one of my best performing rooms. Where most people probably take damage in that room, I usually excel in not. I don't know why. Every now and then the old noggin works time to time. Apple Sodom is not a terrible... Actually, it is a terrible option here for Black Judas, because we can't get any red hearts, so we can't pick them up anyway. Unless that's not true, but even then, I still would just take for the Curved Horn, and, there you go. There's the entire west side of the map. Now we can go over here to the east side. Let's go, shall we? It is incredible. At one point, someone tried to detail, like, what is the most likely cardinal direction that I start every level with. And most of the time, if I could go right, it seemed that I had a tendency to do so. And when I started reading that, I started trying to switch it up. I was like, all right, well, I'm going to make a conscious decision. Here's another dead end, by the way. Try to make a conscious decision to go in a different direction at the start of any given level, and yeah, this just shows you the results here. We are still doing it, and it is quite unbelievable. So the only real trinket that I would even like entertain the thought of taking would be Crack Crown. But the thing is that we haven't had really any big damage upgrades. In fact, I don't think we've had any damage upgrades on this run. We have not. No item that we have taken gives us damage. And no, I don't include the bad PhD pill there because it's not an item, it's a consumable. We would still benefit from the Crack Crown, but, you know, Crack Crown also might be a DPS boost because of Mr. Dolly and the apple, combined with a doubled effect of Mom's Box. So if we see it, then, you know, if we see it, then that will be, well, I mean, there'd be no more argument. It'd be solved. I'm going to take Spear of the Night here, but we got to be careful with our HP. It's a little bit risky. I do have a little bit more faith. I didn't think about it too hard, just because, by the way, dead end and another dead end. I didn't think about the choice too hard there. Wow. I didn't think of the choice too hard there because we have the stopwatch. I'm actually furious that thing not only didn't die, but then shot point blank at us. We can't actually get this red heart, even though we have a bone heart. The bone heart still is worth one hit, so it's just as good as a soul heart. Ringworm and Mom's Box would be a decent tiers up, but not as good as a 4 damage up is from Curved Horn. So we do need to be cautious here with our HP, because obviously, I mean, we only take 2 more hits and then we're dead on the third. So finding some tinted rocks is definitely going to be a priority, and that's the reason why you got to be on your mark. Spot them, especially in these late game levels where they tend to be a little bit more difficult to spot. The most important thing about that room is killing that host before the brimstone turrets go off. Otherwise, you're going to get trapped in that corner and you have nowhere to go. You got to do like a pixel perfect dodge. The hallway just keeps on going. And it's still going. Nice charm effect there. The crowd control by Venus. Got 22 bombs. We should at least try to find the super secret room. An Emperor card. That is a huge pickup for us here. Absolutely massive, massive drop for us. I would say that the Sigil of Baphomet would also be one that I would warrant consideration for over damage, but here we go. Got to play lights out here against Stanley and against Lamb. I'm not going to go for the bomb trick because I always misjudge with the stopwatch, so we can't afford to get hit at all. And stopwatch is key here. Huge hit by, oh my goodness. Depression. Depression absolutely wasted Stanley there. Wow, you don't see that too often. That wasn't me. That was all depression there. Be careful opening up these chests, too. We can't take any of it. And, man, Damocles, if we still had Juice of Shadow, that would be huge. But here we go. We got to play Lights Out. We're not out of the woods yet. We don't have Polaroid Invincibility. We only get two hits, and then we're done. Wherever we dodge from, we're going to leave a bomb at. It's a little bit of a sketchy dodge there, I'm not going to lie. I didn't mean for it to be that close. I meant to cut over a little bit sooner. Thankfully, we were able to bisect that wave there. Whew. Now, that's just good play right there. You gotta give me that. I got to pat myself on the back a little bit there. That was some good play. And, yeah, let's do a victory lap. All right, here we go. 9, Mike, Whiskey, Mike, 3, Yankee, Foxtrot, 4. All right, so fantastic first run there. That being said, we can't really be too complacent right now just due to the fact that, well, we still only have 2 hits and we're dead. So we want to maintain good practice. We've got dominating damage right now. We've got flying. We've got spectral tears. You know, we're in a good spot, but that doesn't mean that we can just sit back and think that we've got everything covered. We don't. But never get complacent in Isaac. That's the one thing that will kill you more than anything else is hubris. Well, that and bad tears. Losing 4 damage, but gaining that, I think it's worth it. Our DPS goes through the roof here. We have much higher DPS with this than we do with 3.8 and not having, or and having 17 damage. The hell? Item room. It is. Ghost Pepper here. Ghost Pepper is going to be a very nice addition to this run as well. Having positive luck ratio is also going to be a big part in getting those procs that we need from the blue fire to help us out, not only on offense, but defense as well. Yeah. Look at that. We just shoot right through the rocks there, courtesy of Spirit of the Night with the Spectral Tears. We get the Mother Transformation too. I tell you what. The Soul Heart in there as well. Now we can start to rest a little bit easier. Don't have to fret about playing too conservative. Okay, Global D6. Again, you're getting a real look at how effective having a higher tears rate is, and on top of that, you combine that with the charm effect from Venus, and I mean the monsters, you know, all mobs, they just run into each other and just waste themselves. It's great. Reason why Little Sissy is so well regarded, highly regarded, I should say, in the Isaac community. This crack crown. Now we have to take stock here to see exactly how this is going to affect our stats. That's pretty good. We go back to 17 damage. Oof. Honestly, I think crack crown, I think it gets the dub here. It does lower our tears rate by a little bit, but man, that damage. The damage, movement speed, and shot speed. Shot speed is a crucial part of the effectiveness of Tech Zero. Esau Jr. Yeah. And we could use Esau Jr. just to see what we would get from a roll, but I'm not going to. It's not like I'm going to stick with it, so. But a roll is here. There it is. And that is what we were looking for. Getting Mom's Purse here is going to be absolutely massive for us because now We can hold on to the cancer trinket and hold on to Crack Crown. So there's no, there's not even like a, there's not even a quarterback controversy now. We just get both of them. Out of the blanket for deflecting that gurgling. Guppy's eye. Yeah. Man, I'm really tempted to take both here. That might be a little too greedy, though. We don't need the tears up. The damage is also, I mean, the damage is pretty good, but yeah, I'm gonna be conservative here. Not throw away a surefire thing. Yes, we had the four room on the last floor, which I didn't end up using, but we didn't really need it. I mean, I guess technically we could have rolled Esau Jr., I guess. But there comes a certain point where like stuff like that, I don't really worry about playing super optimally in a run that, for all intents and purposes, is one, right? You don't want to play sloppy either, but, you know, at the same time, you know, I'm not going to beat myself up because I forgot to use a four room once. These trinkets in the doorway is going to get a little bit annoying, but huge chest here. Tons of money. And you're seeing the absolute value that we're getting out of having Spectral Tears. Five room is going to allow us to redo the floor. Latch key, which is going to be a nice luck upgrade. And Death's Freaking Touch, which is going to give us the ability to have Piercing Shots, Spectral Tears, and Tech Zero on a build like this. Look out. Take charge, baby, too. Come on. On charge, baby. Do it. Just go ahead and repeat the process here and do it all again. And I mean, piercing shots with this build is just, that's just stupid. I mean, the amount of damage that Tech Zero does, just piercing alone is going to be enough to kill the biggest bosses in the game. But if you add on to that the proc rate of Ghost Pepper and the damage multiplier that we have from Black Judas, dude, forget about it. Forget about it. Tarot Cloth, which is going to give us two judgments, which I'm just going to go ahead and yeet right now. Back to a 45% devil deal chance. The shadow is a nice little pickup for us as well. Just gives us a little bit of extra protection in case we needed it. Which, I mean, our main damage, our main protection is our DPS. Yeah, don't even try, Ragman. Don't even try. Your goose is cooked. And the compass was a nice little addition for us that allows us to at least get a general thought about where we're going. Five room proving to be very useful for us on that last floor. And we'll take two of the nails. The nail is nothing special. I mean, if you can time it right, the invincibility that you get does help, and it does save you from Damocles, I believe. But there's absolutely no way to predict the timing on that with Damocles. There's just none. Yeah, we don't need the Book of Shadows. Give me Mama Mega. I'm not gonna use her here. I will definitely use her on Steps 2 for the boss rush. Not that we're gonna need any help of getting there anyway, but It's fun to use Mama Mega, you know? We haven't used her in a while. Get more tiers upgrades, which is just going to give us even more DPS with the shot speed to boot. Piercing and the spectral. Oh, man. It's a dream. A dream run to end the week. Well, end the regular week, anyway. Have a little ways to go before the week actually ends. Also known as the weekend. Look at that. You know that we've got tons of damage when those hush flies go down like regular flies. Ares is going to give us a movement speed upgrade. Excuse me. That I will also happily take. You might be wondering how come I'm not using the Mom's Box anymore. Truth be told, we don't really need anything else at this point. 68% deal with the devil. We really don't need any more trinkets. We've got the best loadout that we can possibly get. You could argue maybe Curved Horn, but nah. Actually surprised that the... Okay, yeah, I was going to say, the Mom Hand should not have been able to live through that. Apologies to Jam Jar Boy. Mom Mega is just going to lay the smackdown on everything. So I might as well get maximum value out of it. Like in this room here. Didn't actually clear because the hosts, of course. But we're still looking for like crawl spaces and stuff too. It gets us also guaranteed entrance into the secret room and super secret room for free. But you know, the guppy item there, but oh, okay, I was going to say, we didn't get... And it doesn't give us two guppy items because we have Mom's Box, even though that would be incredible if it did. There are Fool cards, so we don't actually have to do Boss Rush if we don't want to, but we probably will anyway. Just for S's and G's. We're lucky we might even get another 5 room here and possibly get a second Boss Rush, but that did not happen, unfortunately. Use the strength card. Strength card we can use for a devil deal or just general damage. Big damage upgrade. I'm not going to go in the shop because I don't remember. Did we blow up our donation machine already or not in this run? I don't remember if we did or not. I'm going to go ahead and leave it. Three soul hearts from something, I don't know. We get Juice's Shadow again. I mean, hell, why not at this point? It's basically free because of these soul hearts here. Sissy! How you doing, little sissy? Sissy! Little sissy. It's actually Big Sissy because we have BFF. Big Sissy's here. Look at her. She's here in the clear. She's meant to be feared. That's not true at all. You don't fear Sissy. Well, maybe the enemies do. Dude, Little Horn die already. Little Sissy kicking off a Friday in the mosh pit. No, Allie's probably going crazy right now. She's probably gone so crazy that she even probably left a comment about it. She's writing the comment as I speak right now. I can see it happening. That's not true. I can't see it happening, but I can definitely see it happening. Not in the literal sense. Look, you know what I mean. Little Sissy. So on top of us having the Venus Charm effect, we also have the Sissy Charm now. And there's Sigil of Baphomet, which is, again, a fantastic trinket, but none that we're interested in at this point. And again, this is... kind of proves my point that we don't care what we get from Mom's Box. We already have the best loadout. And then we get Game Breaking Bug, which, yep, certainly is an item. Little sissy, how you doing? Got a fancy schmancy eternal mob up there. I haven't seen one of those in a while. Emperor card, which I will absolutely take. Crawlspace. That crawlspace actually wasn't located underneath the tinted rock either, so it's a little bit odd that we managed to find it. We get butt bombs as well. I mean, we shoot once and everything dies. As long as we hit, of course. I mean, when the lightning, the connected lightning of Tech Zero just hits anything with this damage, on top of us having the piercing shots, it's just game over. It is just a massive amount of damage to survive, and the game just can't do it. Good job, little sissy. Gonna give us the bookworm effect here. I might as well hold on to it. Buttless chub! He ain't got no butt. There you go, down goes mom's heart. We get another devil deal here. Of course, we get the devil deals when they don't matter anymore. And yeah, let's go. I just wanna show you all what it does to old Hushy. Old Hushy has no chance here. Absolutely zero chance. Get a quarter just because. Yeah, we'll take Mom's Pearl for a range and luck upgrade. Sorry, Leech. Epiphora is going to be helpful for us. Eden's Blessing is going to give us another Tears Up as well. Okay, good. Yeah, we hadn't blown up our donation machine. Good. I was hoping that there was going to be a charge, full charge, so we can use Telepathy for Dummies, but oh well. All right. Now, this may not be the most impressive Hush kill, but just watch the damage come out. And remember, the blue fire of Ghost Pepper is also going to cancel out any shot that it hits. So we're incentivized to stay pretty close. I mean, look at health. Look at the health of Hush. Look at that. Sissy! Yeah. Didn't even take any damage there because of the blanket, and down goes Hush. Absolutely untouched and unscathed. What a run. What a run to end the week on, man. That was a good week of runs. We had synergies that we've never seen before. We had a fantastic Wacky Wednesday. And, you know, ending the work week off right here on a Friday with little sissy Black Judas Death's Touch Tech Zero combo. You gotta love it. We use the Emperor card to sail it home. So thank you for watching, everybody. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click, make sure you click the like button, leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite synergy is with Tech Zero. And of course, thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, well, hang on a second. Now that we got Polyphemus, I at least have to go see what happens to Delirium. Polyphemus and Tiny Planet now. I mean, just look. We are the storm, friend. I have no idea where Delirium is. And it doesn't really matter. The longer, just because of the nature of Tiny Planet, the longer that they stay in the air, the faster and more tears that we get to rotate around us. Because it's piercing. This is not going to go the way the game thinks it's going to go. If the game had any thought in its totally arbitrary and non-sentient mind that it was going to beat us on this run, it's now super duper over. Like ultra mega crazy over. That's about the only damage you're going to get on us, game. No idea where that bomb went. All right, let's try this again. I'll take the small rock. Just because it's a huge damage up. I wasn't sure if it was going to affect our tears rate with Crack Crown, though. I thought it might. Also, remember, we have Epiphora, so we can just continue to hold in one direction. Start to gain even more tears with this insane damage. And, yeah, this is looking like one of those times where Delirium is going to be the last enemy that we see. And honestly, that's fine. We're just dominating everything here. We'll take the caffeine pill just for movement speed. We can fly through this level a little bit faster. Okay. All right. Again, look at our tiers right here. 6.89. This is with Polyphemus. That's because of Epiphora. I don't know why I went over here. So the last door we go into is going to be Delirium, as expected. And here we go. Got hit before the foot even landed. Yeah, we are the storm, friend. I don't know where Delirium was during all that. We're somehow still taking damage, but look at this. Yeah, that's a solid way to end the week. So give it a thumbs up, everyone, if you enjoyed this. Remember, we're trying to get over 3,000 likes to keep the like streak going. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Have a great weekend, everyone. And until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Kylie Nupp, Ephrain, Lasidius Dex Ludex, Nate Meldick, and Brittany Conyers. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.